This week, Republican Governor Ron DeSantis of the state of Florida made a comment saying basically that teachers, maybe not just in Florida, but perhaps all over the country, are actually telling kids that they need to switch their genders. Here is his exact quote. "This will be for elementary school kids where they're instructed to tell them, you may have been born a boy, that may have been what you said, but maybe you're really a girl. That's wrong. That has no place in school, so that is happening in our country. Anyone that tells you it's not happening is lying to you." I love that he threw in that last line, because he knows he's lying. So he's trying to cover his bases and say that, oh, anybody who says I'm lying, they're lying, right? Trying to cut off the criticisms before they come. Oh, but they still came. They came all the same. Because pretty much everybody on Twitter that's not a diehard MAGA idiot was asking Ron DeSantis a simple question. Where's the evidence? Can you prove that this has happened literally anywhere in this country? That teachers are walking up to their students and saying, hey, I know you were born a boy, but you're probably a girl. Hey, I know you're a girl, but have you considered being a boy? That's not a thing that is happening anywhere. Because if it were, if there was a single instance of this happening, Republicans would be hyping it on every single conservative media outlet in this country 24 hours a day. People like Ron DeSantis would be showing clips. They would be out there having press conferences every hour talking about the one specific incident that happened. But they're not, because it doesn't happen. He is lying to you. In fact, one of the criticisms here from Dr. Ellen Greaves, an attorney, who asks, how do they have time to come up with the garbage? Imagine what they might accomplish if they dedicated their energy and time to constructive endeavors benefiting all. And that's a great point. If Republicans didn't have to spend so much time creating fake issues, they'd actually be able to address real issues, right? They could be tackling real problems instead of creating imaginary problems, then coming up with solutions for those imaginary problems. You know, DeSantis is a great example right here in the state of Florida, where he has been waging one of the worst culture wars in American history for the last 18 months. We have housing prices that have soared higher, housing and rent prices, soared higher and faster than any other state in the country in the last 18 months. We are now officially one of the top most unaffordable states to live in this country. And he's done literally nothing about it. Half the state right now is getting screwed over because they allowed a merger of our power companies. They raised the rates on everybody, and people are getting squeezed out, having to ration their electricity because they can't afford the new rates. He's done nothing about that. And he has been petitioned. Republicans and Democrats have asked him, do something, but he's done nothing. Because he's too busy, you see. He's too busy sitting there in his office trying to come up with fake problems so he can create fake solutions so he can sell those to his low information base. And that is exactly what this is. This is an assault on teachers. It's why we have such a massive teacher shortage, by the way, here in the state of Florida. And he's only going to make it worse, because he wants to have an enemy. And right now, these teachers that don't even exist, but the anger will be taken out on real teachers. That's who Ron DeSantis has decided to make his big political enemy as he heads towards re-election.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.